I'm Kathi Culver. I'm a collage artist. I am with the Southern Oregon Guild. And I love to collage because it takes images and puts what's in my heart or things that have affected me, beautiful things I've seen or that I've created in my mind. It puts them for the world to see. That's what I love about collage. I am going to collage a goose egg, holes drilled, poked, washed, yolk blown out. And eggs are kind of nice because they're a little bit rough to begin with. And I'm going to use tissue paper or handmade paper and some cutouts using my glue. We need a multi-purpose wall adhesive or wallpaper paste, more or less $5.99, a cat, and white glue, and water. Maybe. Okay, so to proceed, I'm just gonna pour a little bit of water and I pour in a little bit of glue. That's all. Then I take my trusty little whisk, or if you don't have a whisk, I have used a little plastic fork. And I stir it all up. Do not whisk air into this. You want to keep your whisk at the bottom and just stir it. Because when you add your wallpaper paste, a little at a time, you don't want to incorporate bubbles in, because then you'll get bubbles in your collage. So you just do a little at a time. And this is pretty much guesswork. And you stir, 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 keeping it. I'm getting some bubbles, I see. So I'm just gonna go like this. And you want to just make sure that the big flakes are gone, that they're all moistened. And then you're just going to let it sit for a little while. And it'll thicken up. When you start with water, use cold water only. Because if you use warm water, you will make wallpaper paste, and that will be bad news. So here I have some glue already made, and it's thicker, kind of bloppy. I'm stirring it up, no bubbles. And you want to stir it for probably several minutes when you first get started. This is going to be part of it, huh? Paste is thick, like almost, not quite tapioca pudding, but it's thick. So I take it and I spread it on my egg. And I lay it down. Some people, they use the brush to brush it on. I gently just lay it down with my finger. Sometimes if you get it too wet, the tissue paper tears. Smooth down the outsides, get all the wrinkles out that you can. And move on to the next. And this is just going to be like a little backdrop, a background for your images. Now I'm going to take this part right here and stick on one of those because I want to see how it works. Oops. So this is thicker paper. I'll do it right here. So I'm going to use my brush. I like the little stray hairs coming off of this. Ah! So as your paper dries, it's going to want to pull up a little bit. And the edges may move or come unsealed or get wrinkly. So you just need to always make sure all the air bubbles are pressed out. Wow, that's kind of nice. Okay. You want to clean off as much of your glue as you can. Don't have a lot of excess because it'll take longer to dry. It's always good to have something to put your egg on. I'll watch it not work. It's too fat. So generally for a small ornament, you would have to tend to it maybe every several minutes for maybe 15 minutes. Just to make sure that it's wanting to pull up. So you just go through, smooth it very gently. There's some air trying to get in. And after a while, when you get a lot of your egg done with the background, it's going to be really wet. So you just have to let it sit for maybe 10-15 minutes until it's dry as you monitor it, and then you can put your images. You can finish your egg and then put the images on. If you let air get under here, it will eat up your collage from the inside out and it'll just pull away and separate everything. So I'm going to put this up and let it sit for a little while and dry a little bit. For this next phase, we will need an egg with the background tissue paper on it. We will need images, cut out. We will need glue and a whisk, just to make sure it's all stirred up really well. I choose my images for little things like this. Number one priority is it has to be small. I tend to go for images that are nice, positive, universal images. Hearts and stars, eggs, but anything bright. Bugs, nests. A lot of things with bright colors seems to attract me, for sure. This egg, I already have begun with images. And so I need to put some on the back. Since I have eggs on the bottom here, I think I'm gonna put eggs on the bottom here. So I reach right in, I take some of my glue, I put it on the front and the back, and I'm very, very gentle, but I start rubbing. And you wanna get it, instead of feeling like paper, you wanna get it so it feels like fabric. You gently rub it in, and if you rub too hard, you'll know because some of the color will come off of your image. Since it's on a rounded object, it will be put on a rounded object. I always make sure that the edges of my image are really, really flexible, because if they're not, they won't lay flat on the egg. So I make sure I rub it all in. Sometimes I take my fingernail and just gently scratch the image. Not enough to make a real gouge, but just to rough it up a little bit so the glue goes inside. After a while, the glue is getting absorbed and it's not as much glue on the outside. So now I take it and I smooth all the grains of the image going in the same direction. And then I determine where I'm gonna put it. I think I'm just gonna lay it down right here. Smooth, gently. And here you'll see, it doesn't really want to curve, but you just gently but firmly push down your images. And then just let it sit for just a minute until the glue firms up just a little bit. I see it's pulling apart from the egg. So it's time for me to go back in. And smooth it down. And then let it sit. And I'm gonna get a wet washcloth for my hands. Is it coming up yet? Okay. So while this is drying a little bit more, I can take a star. Oh. And I'm just rubbing, rubbing, I think I'll just put that right over that egg. And I continue to go around the outside of the egg with fresh glue because it wants to pull itself up. The thicker images, like calendar pages or the outside of magazines, like the cover, like this is, it's a little bit thicker and you have to work a little bit longer at getting the glue in. Yeah, it's folding really nicely now. And I think I'll put that little heart right there. When you rub this image onto the egg, sometimes the images have a way of sliding. If you're a little too strong at pushing it on, like the whole picture will move. So be aware that it's where you want it to be. I think because I did this gold, I wanted to have some kind of, like it being a goldeny, yellowy kind of a thing. Yeah, another one might be totally different, like bright colors and bright, or black and white. I was going to say I like to keep along the same color lines as keep it uniform, but I don't really know if that's true all the time. I'm just going to let this sit. Even though I know I'm going to still have to work on this egg down here. So how I finish this off, when this is all dried, I usually let it dry overnight, or 8 hours, or overnight. And sometimes I just decide I want a little bit of glitter on it. So if I can squeeze this. I just put it right on there. Just a little. So after you glitter glue this whole thing and let it dry, then it's complete. So then I would just let this sit and dry. An option that you can use, you can either leave it like this and the glitter glue kind of holds, makes a little bond and protects it. Or I use a gloss acrylic. I order mine online from Artist Supply Company. Some that don't have any glitter, but I want glossy. I'll put a coat of varnish on. Oops, I should be doing it over here. And for the varnish, I know some people like spray varnish. I don't. I like brush on varnish because I varnish a lot of things. So, now I'll just let it dry. Oh, what's this big? No. That way. Okay, well, have fun. Be good.